Hey everyone, if you really know me, you know that I am an Apple fanboy. I've been an Apple fanboy even before the iPhone. I've had all the different types of iPhones. I have Apple Watch, I have the Vision Pro, I have all different MacBooks. Really the only reason why I pull up Windows on my device is to use Storyline. I'm an Apple guy, so it's kind of painful to talk about Microsoft products. However, the Microsoft product that I'm going to be talking to you about today is so good, I had to show it and I had to talk about this. Now, it is an AI product called Copilot, and I'm specifically going to be focusing on the Copilot integration inside of PowerPoint, because that is in the learning and development world, that's something that we still use a lot, or we could easily create as well. I don't get into the debate of, you know, ethical, which I think is important debates, but it's not something I'm more focused on how. I'm going to show you how to do it. You can decide when to use it or how to use it and everything like that. So if you do try to make a comment of the debate, I will not respond to that. However, it's cool to see. To me, it's honestly an impressive thing to see and to be able to take advantage of. So if you want to check out Copilot, go to Microsoft.com. You can just search for Copilot to find, or you can just go to copilot.microsoft.com to get right to the application. But I do want to show you the pricing, because you can see right here, Copilot for Microsoft, it's about $30 a month. So if you're paying for it yourself, it's a little pricey. But if you're thinking about using like the paid version of ChatGPT, it's about, you know, it's a little bit more than that. But what it can do, if it's going to save you a whole lot of time, then it might be worth it. So just check that out. All right, so let's get into the tool. If you have subscribed to Copilot and you have PowerPoint pulled up, you'll see a new option here. Now, if you don't have Copilot, you can still use some AI capabilities, which I'll show you as well. But inside of Copilot, if I click on this option here, whatever Microsoft Office 365 that I am doing inside whatever application, you will have this Copilot prompt. And it does different things if you're inside of Excel. It does different things if you're inside of Outlook, or different things if you're inside of PowerPoint like this or Word. You can see here, I can chat, respond to questions, and you can see that I can create a presentation or add a slide or something like that. So let's go ahead and play around with this. And I could go in and view prompts as well. If I click on create a presentation about, if I want to edit, add an image of, and then you can see you can add specifically an image, or how can Copilot help, give a specific example from a presentation on how to improve it for leadership review or something. Those are the different types of prompts that it can do. But it can even create something from scratch. I'm going to say create a presentation on avoiding harassment in the workplace. This is a common training that we create inside of this industry. So just with that simple prompt, let's go ahead and see what happens here. Depending on the prompt, depending on your internet connection, it may take a little while, but it's going to go ahead and create a presentation for me. All right, so we have preventing harassment in the workplace. Let's go into here and you can see what is harassment. We have different bullet points. We have different images as well. And you can see different things right there. The content you still want to double check. You want to do that with AI no matter what. You at least have a foundation, but maybe this could help generate ideas, or help, like if you don't know where to start, help with an outline or something like that. But the fact that it can create a presentation on the fly is pretty sweet. If I come into here on this slide, there's a couple of other things that I could do. There is this tool called Designer. Designer will take the content and it will give you different types of options. Now we can swap out the image, so don't let the image kind of fool you there. We can go ahead and swap out the image, but it does give us different types of designs that we can choose from. I like that, but I can then come into my image under the picture formats, and I can go ahead and change the image right here. If I select this drop-down box, and I can change from stock images. Or, I don't even know if this will work yet, but let's go ahead, change the image to a bright idea. Okay, so it doesn't look like it's going to change the image there. I thought it could, maybe if I go back into edits, maybe I'm prompting it wrong. Add an image of, so I can add an image, of a light bulb. There we go. You can see that it automatically adapts with the image too. We have two different types of images. We can swap those out, but it's automatically added that image of the light bulb. Now, I could even come in here, like, summarize this presentation for me. If somebody gives you a PowerPoint and you just want to get it summarized, you could do that pretty quickly as well. Even the fact of, like, pulling this up in Excel, if you had, like, an Excel piece of data and having it summarize the data for you, allows you to, I don't know, for me, if it is a huge PowerPoint, I'm like, just give me the key points sometimes. This would allow me to do that kind of thing or organize this presentation. Or I'm going to go ahead and say animate this slide. I want to have some animations. Let's see what it can do here. You can see there's my animation. So it automatically starts to animate my objects and I can go ahead and tweak those as well. Just a lot of different things that I can do here. And I want to show you a couple other things. I want to add a slide. So let's say add a slide about historical events surrounding harassment. Oh, let's try a different one. So add a slide about historical events regarding technology. So it's not really specifically about this topic, but we'll see what it comes back with. So there we go. It automatically added that, gave me some historical events. It also has some notes down here. So I do even have a slide where I have different quick history here. Here's a cool thing about the designer. If I come into the designer, it will pick up on the fact that it has dates and it has some type of information. And it will recommend, you can see here, that it has some recommendations of like timelines. We can add the description right here on different timelines. So that is one of the awesome things about Designer, which does come for free, or it's part of the subscription. It just gives me a bunch of different options here. One other kind of AI technology that I think is pretty awesome is if you go into the, not record, but slideshow, there is this Rehearse with Coach. And if you click on this and start rehearsing, you can see here that I'm going to start rehearsing. Let me actually swap this out. I'm going to start rehearsing and it's going to pick up on the camera and it's going to pick up on my cadence and what I'm talking about. So what is harassment? Harassment is any unwanted behavior that creates immediate hostile or offensive work environment. Harassment can be physical, verbal, non-verbal, things like that. So if I then come in here, you can see that it will give me a summary of how I'm doing. Now, if I turned on, and I didn't turn it on for this one, but if I inserted the video where you can have like live video on the presentation, it would actually even keep track of like how much I'm looking at the camera or eye contact or if I'm looking away, different things like that. You can see here my pitch. Good pitch variation increases liveliness in your speech and so forth. Fillers, fantastic. I did say a couple at the end, but repetitive language, I was reading most of the time. And so forth. And so it's just an awesome way to be able to practice your presentations, practice your content, and get feedback about your content as well. And I think the part that I was looking at is Cameo. If you turned on Cameo here, then there's my Cameo. It would give you some feedback on that. So if you even turn on that Cameo feature, you can have your recording right in there and get the rehearse information as well. That is the Copilot right inside of PowerPoint. There's Copilot inside of Excel. There's Copilot inside of Word. You could have it generate some files for you. So if you have Copilot, you don't actually even need to have ChatGPT because it's basically integrated ChatGPT in there. And in fact, I'm gonna go to copilot.microsoft.com. It also has image generation. There is so much that you can do with Copilot right inside of here. You can see right here, I can go ahead and have it generate different images, designers, vacation planner as well. Hopefully that gives you some ideas. And once you have this PowerPoint, in fact, I want to pull this up and I'm going to save this. I could even come in with that PowerPoint and I can click on import, go into import PowerPoint and import that PowerPoint right inside of Storyline and use that as a starter point with my Storyline project. Now, Articulate is coming out with their own AI beta, but it's going to be mostly with Rise. So this is a way that you can actually take advantage of AI inside a Storyline. Hopefully this is at least giving you a few ideas and seeing what's possible with the Copilot inside of PowerPoint. If you want to see more of this, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows my channel to continue to grow and for me to create these videos for you. If you have any feedback or want to see anything else that Copilot or Storyline or anything else can do, go ahead and leave a comment down below. I take a look at those comments and anything that you may have a suggestion for, I love that as well. My goal for this channel is really to help you become the best learning developer that you can be and really stretch the tools that we have here and get the most out of the tools. And so if you have anything else, please let me know. But that's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.